Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the CHOMPI Clubhouse. Today, we are going to talk all about sample management and how to use CHOMPI's workflow to pass samples around, to store and recall your presets and your loops. So get yourself comfy, maybe pour yourself your favorite cup of tea or your favorite beverage, because we got a lot of exciting stuff to talk about here. First and foremost, I want to address the fact that this is not meant to be a step-by-step tutorial video, but more like a crash course overview, just to help clarify and to demonstrate some of the use cases of how to navigate through CHOMPI's workflow, okay? So if you feel a little bit overwhelmed, that's okay. I'm gonna be making some more bite-sized videos, which will be more like video manuals for you on the resource page of our website in the next couple of months, okay? So to kick things off, we have a couple things we have to talk about in a specific order here, because we can't just jump right into examples. But by the end of the video, I'm hoping that everyone will understand the basics of the different engines and why they are unique, as well as how to actually navigate parts of the shift menu and pass samples around. So we're gonna talk about some stuff, and then I'm gonna show some examples at the end, okay? So let's just dive right in. CHOMPI actually has four different sections or areas where samples exist. And first, we need to talk about the ones that you are most likely familiar with, but are the ones that are maybe more like what I like to think of as like sketch pads or temporary workspaces, places to explore ideas, but not necessarily to save or recall ideas. And we call these buffers. The first is the CHOMPI buffer, and the CHOMPI buffer is when you flip the switch up and you make a new recording, you're making a recording into the CHOMPI buffer. Now, where do you access the buffer? Well, that's this 15th special preset white key over here on the end. And you'll notice there's a little icon underneath it. That's the same icon right up here. So that space is what we call a temporary or a destructive buffer, meaning that when you make a new sample, each time you are replacing the previous sample, and it's gone forever, just so you know. This is a way to make things really fast and exploratory without having to feel like every single thing you're doing has to be super precious, right? When you do want to save, we'll get to that in just a second, then you can actually store those into some presets and other sections of the synth. So we'll talk about that in a second, but that's the CHOMPI buffer. The looper buffer is more like what I like to think of as an actual doodle pad, right? So you take your samples, and in this case, maybe let's think of them as like colored pencils or something, and you're gonna sketch compositions with them into the looper. So you can layer them and you can create different moods or attitudes or express yourself through this sound palette, I guess. It's like, I don't know, in my mind, I like to think of sound and color as very interchangeable, so bear with me if that's not how you think about it, but it does make sense, right? Your samples that you're collecting, they're just like different colors in your palette, and you're gonna be able to use those to make different sketches or compositions into the looper. Now, an important thing to note about the looper is that it will erase itself every single time that you power cycle the device. So when you power off CHOMPI, it wipes the slate clean, a little bit like an Etch-a-Sketch, and then everything, when you bring it back on, will be like a fresh slate. So again, both of these spaces are not designed to be precious, and the material is meant to be more exploratory in nature, okay? And then that leads us to the other two engines that we need to talk about, which are JAMMI mode and CUBBI mode. Now, I know they're kind of silly names, but really all they're referring to is the two different ways that you can save and perform samples in CHOMPI. So what are they? How do they work? We'll just talk about them one at a time here. JAMMI mode is our chromatic engine. And if you don't know what that means, it basically means that we have a single audio file that is played at different speeds on our keyboard. So in the root speed is this middle C key right here. When you go up the keyboard, you're gonna play the file faster, and that also means the pitch is gonna go higher. And then when you play it slower down this direction, your pitch is going to be lower, all right? So that's JAMMI mode. Now, one thing to note here is that it's one audio file being played with different, what we call instances on the keyboard. So you can play up to 7 notes at a time, all of the same recording just being played at different speeds. So that's JAMMI mode. CUBBI mode, on the other hand, has the ability to have up to 14 different samples, one sample per key. And you can play those up to seven, you know, just like with JAMMI mode, seven notes at a time. So that means you could essentially play seven different samples at a time, and each sample has controls for each of these three parameters. Whereas I forgot to mention, JAMMI mode, when you store a preset, all three of these knobs get stored for the one sample. Now that you know the four different areas where samples are living on CHOMPI, how do you navigate between them? Well, that's where the shift menu comes in. So for those that don't know or haven't used other electronic instruments, the shift key essentially opens up secondary functions across the entire device when you're holding it down. And this is identical to the way that the shift key works on like a typing keyboard, right? Like if you want to access an exclamation point, you hold down the shift key and you press one, and that brings up the exclamation point instead of the one. So it's the exact same thing down here. Now you'll notice when I hold it down, you'll see these different colored LEDs. And these LEDs are telling you a bunch of information if you know what you're looking for. I'm not going to go into every secondary function across the device today. However, we do need to address a number of the functions down here on the keyboard. So let's just run through really quickly all of what these keys do. Starting with the white keys. You'll notice that the white row, we have numbers not only underneath here, but we also have a LED that lights up right now as purple. And this is indicating that we have a sample saved on one of those keys. So let me just show you what that does here. So I'm going to hold down shift. I'm going to select number 3. You'll notice it switches from purple to white. And now we can hear that preset. And I can jump to 7. I can jump to 12. And I can do this, and this we're in JAMMI mode right now. Now I can do this per bank. So over here, you'll see we have also a purple LED. And this is saying that we are in bank A of JAMMI mode since we're on the left key. If I hit this key again, you'll notice we switch to the gold bank. And then I hit it again, we have a teal bank. Now there's no keys that light up here, whereas in the gold bank, we have some keys lighting up. And that's to tell you that there isn't a preset on those keys, right? So that key on the left is our JAMMI mode banks. The key on the right, you've guessed it, is our CUBBI mode banks. So I can go to, like, let's say the teal bank in CUBBI mode. And now we have different drum samples or drum loops on each of these keys. So three banks for each of the engines, and you toggle through them using these ones here. All right, moving on, I'm just going to quickly go through these ones. These three are for your input select. So when you want to record for the built-in microphone, it's this key on the left-hand side. When you record with the line input, it's the middle key. And that actually does have an auto recognize. When you pull the jack in and out, it will notice and it'll switch over to the aux input. And then this final one is our resample mode. And we're going to talk about that in another video. But when you want to resample the final output, you can select that and then you can sample whatever it is sending out, but in a digital way. The next one, these two right here are for our effects position. So by default, the effects is going to happen like you see it here. It's going to be in the chain, the signal path, pre-looper, meaning your effects are going to happen and then they're going to get recorded into your loops. If you select this option, it'll be post looper, and that allows your effects to happen after your loops. And you can move them at any time, so you could stack your and layer your effects if you want to. The ones we really want to focus on though today are going to be these three keys here, which are save, copy, and erase for our preset management functions. If you ever need a quick reminder of what any of the keys or functions do, on the back side of the unit, we've printed a simplified version of the quick start guide. And this is just handy information to have with you wherever you're going to take CHOMPI, especially when you're first starting out. Over time, as you get more comfortable with the workflow and you maybe look to this less and less, you can actually pull the back panel off and flip it around. And there's a more simplistic design on the other side. So you'll have both options to work with. So now that you know the four different areas and you understand at least the basics of the shift menu, why don't we actually just do an example? Why don't we try one? we're going to use our little Game Boy emulator here. Let's turn it on and let's get some sound going by flipping the switch up. All right, let's make a sample. Perfect. So I'll turn that off. Now our sample is here and we are in the CHOMPI buffer. So this sample, if I were to hit the key again, flip the switch up and record a new one, it's going to be gone, right? But let's say we like it and we want it. So I'm gonna maybe trim it a little bit. We can add a little effects to test that out a little bit. Ooh, that's nice. And let's also change the pitch of it a little bit. It's easy to get carried away. But let's say that our sample is the way that we want it now, and now we want to save it to one of the JAMMI mode slots. All right, so in order to do that, we hold down the shift key and we activate the save function. Now you notice I don't have to hold shift anymore and our keyboard starts blinking. Now what CHOMPI is asking you to do is to pick a destination. When you activate save, it's always going to pull from the source of the CHOMPI buffer. And so we don't even have to worry about the source. We're going to just choose the destination. You'll notice that the keyboard right now is blinking purple, and that's saying that we could save into one of those slots, but we're going to override whatever sample is there if we select it. So I don't want to do that. I want to find an empty slot. So this one, we have some gold keys and then we have some white keys, and those white keys are showing, all right, well, that one's an empty one. Let's put it in 11. Now you notice we have blue for save and then blue on our destination. And now up here, we're blinking red. So this is the point where you say, are you sure? Is this what you want to do? CHOMPI is basically saying confirm. And if you want to do this, press the CHOMPI key to confirm. If you want to get out of it, all you do is press the save key again and it won't save it. So we're going to confirm it, and now it blinks white. It has to think for just a second, and now we have a preset. So if we go to our number 11 on the gold bank, there's our sound. And it saved the position of these three knobs onto that same preset slot. Now, if I want to, let's say, erase that slot, we do the exact same action. We select red, and then you can see it tells us the ones that have something saved on them. We select red, and then we can confirm it up here. I don't want to erase that one, but I'm just showing you that it's the exact same action. We're just doing it in essentially a destructive way and not an additive way. All right, so I'm not gonna hit this. I'm gonna hit the delete key or the erase key, and it'll get us out of that action. So hopefully that's making sense. Now I want to talk about copying, because copying is almost identical. There's just one added step, and that is we have to pick a source. So we just saved that to preset number 11 on the gold bank of JAMMI mode. Let's move it to 13, for instance. So we're going to do copy. Now it tells us, all right, what do you want to copy? We say, all right, we want to go 11, which turns it green. And now we're going to go to 13, which makes this one blue. So copy is the source and that's green. Blue is our destination and that's save. And again, we just have confirm up here. So we hit confirm. Now it copies it. And now when I do this, you can see we have one in 11 and we have one in 13. Jump to that one and there's our preset again. So pretty simple, right? CHOMPI is basically just asking you questions by blinking its LEDs. And each time that it's blinking, that is requiring an action from you to move forward. Something we haven't talked about is that you can actually copy from any of the four engines or sources into any of the four engines or sources. And this means that you can move things between any of the engines and the looper as well, which is super, super cool. So why don't we try that out? Let's go into one of our banks in CUBBI mode. And you see, I have a bunch of drum loops in here. So I can find one that I like. How about this guy right here? So I'm gonna copy this number 3 into my looper. And I do it the exact same way that I just showed. Activate copy. Press number 3, you'll see it turns green. And then you'll notice up here, we blink. So I'm going to press that, it turns blue, and then confirm. It thinks for a second, and now we have our loop into, or our sample into the looper. So I use that term a lot of times interchangeably, because the nature of these down here is that they are loops, right? Like when you hold it down, it's just going to loop itself. So we can move all of these around, kind of like hot potato for samples. Me and my analogies, I know they're silly. Thanks for bearing with me. But what's cool now is like, now I can change the tempo and speed of my loop by changing the pitch of my looper. And then you guessed it, we can come into here, select another preset. So like, let's do about this guy. Add some effects to that. Let's go effects pre. So it's just gonna be on my chromatic sample. Right? So you can jam along. Also, we could layer recordings into that if we want to as well. I'll just do a simple. Now we select a new preset. Let's do like a bass. I think I have a bass in here somewhere. So yeah, so on and so forth. And that makes things super, super fun. You can then take what you've made up here in your sketch pad, in your looper, and we can save that, we can copy that into a cubby mode slot. So let's do that real quick. That'll be our last example. So let's activate the copy. Now you'll see, because we have a loop in here, we copy from our looper, goes green. Let's select one of the cubby mode banks. Let's use the purple bank, and let's say number 6 here. We go blue, confirm, and now our loop is saved right here. Reverse that baby. So like next time, if I want to bring that same loop I made back into the looper, all I have to do is copy 6 back into my looper, and I'm right back to where I started. As you can see, there are so many different possibilities once you start passing samples from engine to engine. And once you wrap your head around what each engine is doing best and what its strengths are, you can make some incredible stuff with CHOMPI. So I hope at this point you are more excited than overwhelmed, because we are super excited to see what you end up doing with CHOMPI. And if you are overwhelmed, I apologize. I promise it'll get easier, and I'm going to be making some more bite-sized videos that are easy to digest, and those should hopefully help make things a little less daunting. So thanks for bearing with me, and until next time.